I'm Dr. Tim Elder. I'm a board-certified family physician at SIMEDHealth in Gainesville in our High Springs location. So tinnitus or tinnitus is a very common symptom that I see in my office. A lot of patients complain about it. And the biggest complaint they have is that they hear this chronic noise. And it's worse typically for patients when it's quiet, especially at night when they're trying to go to bed. So a lot of patients come in and they want to be diagnosed with what this ringing in their ear is. And there's really not a good way to diagnose this, as it's basically like a diagnosis based on a history that patients give us. Sometimes when I'm really concerned about it, like an atypical type of ringing in the ears, like a pulsatile tinnitus, then there may be additional testing that I do, like a CT scan or MRI of your brain. Also, when you do hearing testing, sometimes that'll also increase our chance that if there's certain things that we can see on a hearing test, that it may be tinnitus related to hearing loss. This is a very difficult symptom for a lot of patients, and first thing they always ask is like, what can I do to prevent this from getting any worse? So first, obviously, we want to know kind of what caused it. And most of the time that I see, the etiology is usually having to do with noise-related hearing loss, and age-related hearing loss. So obviously, you want to avoid different noises and loud things that could make it worse. The other thing, sometimes medications can cause it. So anti-inflammatory drugs, I use aspirin. So obviously, avoiding additional medications that can make that worse would be one of the first steps I'd have for my patients. First thing I usually recommend is that they get hearing testing, and then hopefully if they qualify, then they get hearing aids, because that can make a difference. Having that amplification, hopefully it drowns out some of that noise that they hear. The other thing that you can do is obviously if it's a medication that's causing, you stop the medication. And then there's also noise machines that a lot of people will use at night, or a fan, and that kind of helps kind of drown out the noise that people are hearing. And sometimes that helps patients get to sleep at night.